Good morning, students. My name is Dr. Vishwam. This semester, I'm taking care about the course called Basics of Semiconductor Physics. In the present semiconductor physics, let us look at the what is the introduction about the course. This particular course contains the basic concepts of quantum theory of solids and how the carriers in a semiconductor materials plays an important role in the present electronic gadgets. This course balances fundamental physics and also with respect to the number of applications in the present electronic devices. At the end of the course, the student will learn about how the band structures and the significance in the electronic properties of materials and how the carrier concentration in a semiconductor material varies, and also these carriers are n-type or p-type can be analyzed, and also how this carrier mobility is varying with respect to the temperature and the doping concentration, and which are light emitting material, which are non-light emitting materials can be learned in this particular course. This course contains basically the first part contains about the type of materials, in that intrinsic materials and extrinsic materials, how the mechanism of conduction occurs in an intrinsic material with respect to the temperature, and also with respect to the doping, these materials change into n-type and p-type materials, how the carrier concentration is varying, and also we're learning about the characteristic curves of a semiconducting material like photodiode, light emitting diode, solar cell and tunnel diode, and also what are the applications looking into that particular concept. Let us look the present day the semiconductor applications. The first application we studied is a diode, generally is a p-n junction diode as well as resistive material. Now the transistors, previous olden days we used to use silicon and germanium. At the present market scenario, this semiconductor material changed into the graphene. So if you look at a SIM card or memory card, there are billion number of transistors which stores the information in terms of a bits. And also we have seen the previous slide is a p-n junction diode material. The same p-n junction diode, if you dope with a different concentration, it starts emitting light. This type of material is called light emitting diode materials or laser diode or optically active materials. The major consequence here is the solar cell. The maximum amount of the solar energy can be stored. This is a present challenge task, and also green environment. So how to store that information? So to store the information, we require a semiconducting material which is captured more efficiency of the solar light, that should be converted into the light. And also SSD type. Nowadays all the electronic gadgets are going to be so light, in that we are using the solid state material which can store the information. And also the present market cell phones, they are using a liquid like a organic light emitting semiconducting material which starts emitting light. So the semiconducting materials plays an important role in the present day market applications, and also to use this semiconductor material in a satellites, to make the satellites a satellite device or electronic equipment, this semiconductor plays a crucial role in the learning the subject as well as wide number of applications. So the present reference books I'm following for this particular semiconductor topic, this is Charles Kittel, The Basic Physics, and purely about the working of semiconducting materials and devices by SMG. And somewhere I'm using the attached book of Nanoscience and Technology. At the same time, I'm updating myself from the web of science as well as the MIT web courses. So I'll teach you in the classroom. These are only some of the things I mentioned in the particular slide. The next details I'll update in the soon. Thank you.